Mike, law enforcement authorities here are saying they're not going to reopen the school until they've determined that it's safe to do so, and they haven't disclosed publicly anything about that yet. They met here at 3 o'clock to talk it over. The only thing moving on the property of Covington Catholic High School Tuesday was a patrol car. Such is the state of security concerns 4 days after a student trip to D.C. suddenly went viral, ballooning into controversy and daily drama. According to Commonwealth Attorney Rob Sanders, CovCath closed due to at least dozens, if not hundreds, of threats.
How hard do you have to hate somebody to do that? I mean, you hate somebody you don't even know? I mean, that's the great irony. I want to kill this guy, and why?
Covington Latin, in close proximity to the diocese, canceled classes as well. A few yards away, genuine worry was reflected on the signs held by two people who preferred to let their printing stand without elaboration. Between the parked police cars blocking entry onto the Covington Catholic grounds, a man whose son graduated from the school 8 years ago carried rosary beads and a message he spoke to us about.
Just saying prayers for healing for our country and the divisiveness, and to pray for the children that go to school here.
Those students won't gather Tuesday night to cheer their basketball team, as a mid-afternoon meeting on security was held. The game had already been canceled. Across the street, Notre Dame Academy took extra security precautions, law enforcement advising students there to forego any CovCath spirit wear for the time being. The threats have arrived by every conceivable means of communication.
If they think schools should not be brought back together again today or tomorrow or the next day, I would listen to them.
It's Dr. John Stevenson who added there's something wrong with the society when a school has to close because of death threats. The Covington Diocese says Covington Catholic students, parents, faculty, and staff should stay off campus until further notice. Live in Park Hills, John London, WWT News 5.
John, we've been hearing a lot about these threats. Have police been able to identify anybody making the threats, and what would happen, the consequences, if anybody's caught?
Mike, depending on the nature of the threat, you're talking anywhere from months in jail to years in jail if convicted. We don't know of any arrests being made or they being able to trace anybody. Some of the threats have been posted online. Some, interestingly enough, were wrong numbers. A caller making a threat, dialing someone who had a similar number to Covington Catholic. They thought they had Covington Catholic, but didn't.